I see that your work and your schooling and your life has pretty much been like an extension, like a tree. It's just yes. something that you grew up around, you were born around, and then you just kept kind of growing with that natural path. I think that's something that a lot of people from the United States don't really have the same exposure of, because a lot of times in the United States, we start and it's just, okay, school, job, success. And then at 18 years old, everybody flies the nest and everybody goes to different universities everywhere. And sometimes it's hard to for people to maintain that type of connection with themselves and sort of doing a career that has a sense of purpose.
And may I comment on that?
Sure, sure.
I living in the U.S. for almost 4 years, I noticed that this is also a result of the different way that slavery took place there, of mm-hmm. separating families as well. This happened here as well.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we had to form our families. Another thing that I noticed is that breaking is the connection with the spiritual life through the connection with the religions, African religions here that developed the candomblé with the orishas, that kind of breaks a lineage of ancestry in communication with that, like it creates interferences.
Okay.
It's not really a breakup, because it's not possible to break up something that is really ancestral.
Yeah.
But it creates interferences, because then we'll miss some guidance that comes from a place that you can't see, you can't feel it. But if you kind of mute these voices, you have more interferences. You have a harder time to hear the guidances that come from there. The guidance that will tell you to listen to the elders. Okay? Think about not only material things.
Okay.
Get together and keep going, carrying this tradition, because this brings you faith.
Right.
And this faith puts you stronger. And if you're stronger, you don't have anything to fear, because you know that in hard times, you're going to manage, you overcome.
Wow. So in that sense, it would be better for African Americans to say, hey, you know, we're Africans, we're part of the African diaspora in America. All that's missing is our signal. It's like a radio signal that has static, is what you're saying. The separation caused breakups in the signal of our culture, spirituality, and roots. And so a lot of African Americans are in difficulties with the social order in the United States a lot, and some of the social tensions because
exactly.
of that breaking up due to, of course, slavery and time, but also—
And also capitalism.
Capitalism,
because
and money.
The rights and the religions, the spiritual guidance that we have from Africa, they're mainly based on natural life, the power of the elements, fire, earth, the water.
Mm-hmm.
So if you don't get grounded in nature, is where the spiritual lives will lead you in that you know, alliance, then we do all the mistakes that we are doing now, to get extremely attached to material lives. And this also happens a lot here in Brazil, because we are in a global economy that values much more the things that you conquer, that are material, the money you are able to make, other than the values that you are able to nurture and to motivate on people, such as the conversation that we are having now. It's not as valued as if we were having a conversation about the cars that you can... The dry leads you can with your Instagram and marketing and stuff, you know?
Yeah.
But we need to pay attention to those things, because they are the ones that connect us to nature, to heal ourselves.
Yeah, and I know that Brazil is a very, having traveled to the Northeast and through Minas Bahia, I haven't made it to Rio, ironically, yet. But I mean, I've been to Angra dos Reis. So I've seen
the amazing,
beach.
Yes.
Yeah, like I've seen the connection with the beaches and the mountains and the greenery. And I love that this is a picture from Bahia that I have behind me. So I definitely feel what you're saying. When you're around nature, Like the idea of business, I think is better when it is connected with you. You can still do business and make profit per se, but it doesn't have to be at the exploitation all the time of a group of people or only for the goal of profit. It can be, how about we create something that helps people or encourages people or inspires people or adds a lot of value to people's lives so that everybody can live? Because because one thing nature teaches is the world is so abundant. Like there's so many, like when I see Brazil and the land, I think what a rich country this is. But many people, if they're only looking or thinking about money, they say, oh, well, Brazil doesn't have this or doesn't have that. But I'm like, wow, I mean, if people were working together and certain things were operating a different way, then maybe they would be able to access so much more of this land, the resources and all of that.
Well, we are one of the richest countries in the world. We have the biggest forest with the biggest river a lot of other treasures and the very people and culture. But if we don't pay attention to that, like we just keep destroying as we're doing, as we keep doing to Africa as well.
Yeah.
And it's actually a minority that destroys.
Like a small group.
They are ones with power.
And yeah,
to set up like resorts, 5-star hotels, big stuff that they drive the money to outside of the country instead of like, why responsible tourism come into place? So you need to learn that you are dealing with a lot of small entrepreneurs, and when you are supporting the work of us, like tailoring a trip, and if we have the model of responsible tourism, community-based tourism, valuing our roots, you know that you maybe go to the 5-star hotel or 5-star restaurant, but you can go to a more humble place with a chef that owns the place, that nurtures the family, and the family works all together, and it will offer the best food with a lot of love. You just need to find with the guys, with the local people who know where these dedicated people are.
Right.
Because we are the ones who go to this place and eat their food. We know them by name. They know us.
Yeah.
These are the ones that we need to support.
Right. And these are like some of the smaller posadas and fazendas and different places that little towns that have parts of the culture intact that people can still learn a lot from as well. And I think that's one thing that as Americans, we need more awareness about Brazil in terms of the entire country. And because sometimes I think, I don't know if it's just the bigger businesses that naturally just promote Carnival, Rio, the beaches. But sometimes those other, like information about other cities, like Belo Horizonte, for example, or different parts, like where I am in Campinas, like people don't really know as much about these places.
And yeah,
these
places that happens a lot. The monopoly of these, like everything goes to Rio, Bahia, Amazon, Foz do Iguaçu, as if Brazil was only that. Like Brazil,
right,
for me, is like a labyrinth. It's a place of magnificent beauty and lush that I myself need to find out about. Like the first time I went to Bahia, for example, it completely changed my mind. Being a Brazilian, I said, the way people here dress up, dance, communicate, it completely, woo! I stayed there, I traveled there back to Bahia like 3 times.
Yeah, I want to go back as well. I had a few days that I had a chance there when we were going on the way to Pernambuco, but man, just the little time that I had there blew me away too.
Yes, it blows us away. It's another world. And the same thing when you go to other intense places such as Recife or Chapada Diamantina, Cachoeira da Bahia, these are in Bahia, or Pantanal. I want to go to the Amazon. I haven't been.
Yeah.
There's so much to discover.
Such a great country. So much space and land to explore. So,
and one thing that it's important to tell you is that I'm not here like promoting only Rio EnCantos. We are organizing in order to help other entrepreneurs who are into the understanding that now there is a Black movement for traveling, that we need to develop ourselves, educate ourselves to be not only guides for our own heritage, but to learn how to be travelers of this heritage, to hear our brothers and sisters, and to overcome our differences, stop seeing ourselves as competitors, and educating to get together as small entrepreneurs, to give more of these words that I'm giving you here, sharing with you, that we will be like different channels of this river, so more people can hear, and we can bring more people to get to know the other people who don't speak English, but they they have a lot to offer. They want to receive people there, and we need to be the bridges if we speak different languages.
Yes.